Copyright disclaimer under Section 107 of the Copyright Act 1976. Allowance is made for fair use for purposes such as criticism, comment, news reporting, teaching, scholarship, and research. Fair use is a use permitted by a copyright statute that might otherwise be infringing. Nonprofit, educational, personal use tips the balance in favor of fair use.
Assalamu alaikum. Mr. Moderator, our distinguished guests, brothers and sisters, our friends and our enemies.
Bismillah wa salatu wa salam wa rasulullah wa barak. So you guys might remember my commentary of Sheikh Uthman Farooq's little debate with Anthony Rogers, Sam Shamoun, and David Wood, that I mentioned about a massive mistake that is not a small thing that both Anthony Rogers and David Wood made. And that was when Anthony Rogers kept mentioning about the Chalcedonian Creed and Chalcedonianism, and I didn't know why he was mentioning that, because the Council of Chalcedonia is a little bit of an embarrassment for Christians, because that caused major splits between Christians, right? So I'm not going to go too much into history. There's no way I'm going to try to describe the Trinity for you, right? But what I want you guys to understand is why this is important, and I want you to forward this video to those guys specifically, because they fell into a heresy, a very, very old heresy, and I'm going to prove it without any doubt anyway. So what you need to know is that during this time, it was around the 440s or whatever, there's a man named Nestorius of Constantinople who was close to the emperor at the time. His name was Theodosius II, right? And Theodosius II made him the patriarch of Constantinople, which is like a big thing at that time. And there was a local schism that broke out, which caused Nestorius of Constantinople to say that Jesus had two separate natures, right? One which is divine and one which is human. And there's a man called Cyril of Alexandria, who was, you know, obviously the patriarch of Alexandria at the time. He was a little bit jealous of Nestorius, so he made a big hoopla about this, right? So, long story short, there were, I want to say, about two councils that were done based upon this very thing, right? This whole thing blew up into a massive schism, right, at that time, which caused the church to divide into several different churches. And you'll see later in the video. But anyway, you have three different ways to look at the nature of Jesus, right? The first one is called Nestorianism, which is, again, he has a divine nature and a human nature. Both of them are two separate natures. They don't ever become combined, okay? That's the first thing. That's called Nestorianism. The second is what Anthony Rogers kept mentioning, which is Chalcedonianism. And he kept saying this is the orthodox position, whatever. And this is where you have Jesus having two perfectly unified natures. So they're unified. They're two natures, they're unified. They don't separate. They never divide. And that's one divine and one human nature. And then you have another school of thought called the Monophytism, which is that Jesus has one nature, divine and human. Okay, long story short, right? Theodosius II, he dies, and a new emperor, after a massive, you know, hoopla breaks out after the first two councils, right? The new emperor named Marcian tries a third council, which is called the Council of Chalcedon. Right, it's named after the town that was convened in 451. And basically they came to the conclusion that Jesus has two perfectly unified natures, which is Chalcedonianism, right? And that's divine and human, and they're both unified. But ironically, both the Monophytes and the Chalcedonians, they both unanimously agreed that Nestorianism is heresy. And on top of that, they acted upon this by excommunicating and exiling and basically chasing out anybody who has these Nestorian ideas, right? So that's the whole point of it. And let's see what Anthony Rogers had to say about that.
Soul then
never becomes part of his divine nature.
So his soul will never be part of God.
It'll never be a part of his divine nature. Christ is one person. Right.
I got you. Thank you.
He's
I get
a divine
it.
Person. Okay. He has two natures.
I understand your answer.
Okay.
Thank you. I don't agree with it.
Well, I don't expect you to agree
that's
at this
my,
point.
Okay,
but I'm saying you understand what it is now. Though.
David, do you have the same?
You understand it.
Do you agree
point?
that the soul of Christ is not a part of God?
It's not a part of his divine nature.
You believe that? David Wood.
That's basic Christianity.
I mean, many Christians here, preachers and pastors, have said the soul of Christ is a part of God, right? Well, but you're saying it's not. Okay,
but
understand.
See, I don't know
you're saying the soul of Christ was created, and when Christ died, his soul does not become God.
Absolutely not.
Okay, his soul is in heaven.
So let me just say this then. I can't speak for other Christians, right, in this sense, the people you've talked to, right? I'm not going to say you're misrepresenting them. There are
you can talk to them.
Right? No. I'm saying they might be speaking less than precisely.
Okay.
Or you might be misunderstanding them.
Okay.
I can tell you this, you know, even with all the laugh tracks going on, I can tell you this. Historic, classic Christianity, in terms of its official formal creeds and confessions, teaches exactly what I just told you.
Okay.
Right? The Chalcedonian Creed, which is historic Christianity in its affirmation of the natures of Christ, has always affirmed that Christ had a fully human nature.
Okay.
And those two natures forever are distinct. His human nature could never be his divine nature. The Chalcedonian Creed, which is historic Christianity in its affirmation of the natures of Christ, has always affirmed that Christ had a fully human nature.
Okay.
And those two natures forever are distinct. His human nature could never be his divine nature.
So the soul of Christ is not a part of God.
It's not a part of his divine essence, his nature, right?
His human nature can never be his divine nature. You're out there pushing Nestorianism and calling it Chalcedonianism. That's like me as a Salafi saying Allah lives in everywhere and everything. But I'm Salafi. You are so goofy. You and James Wood. James Wood just like, yep, I concur, sir. Yes, sir. The very same 1600-year-old heresy that the church had the Chalcedonian Council to begin with in order to fight against, you have confirmed. So now that you have confirmed this heresy, and David Wood out there, yes sir, I do declare, okay? Doesn't that make y'all heretics? Now there's no way that Anthony Rogers didn't know what he was, affirming was Nestorianism. If he mentioned the Chalcedonian creed, then he knows very well what he's reciting is a heresy. So the question is, why did he do it? Is because he's banking on you Muslims not knowing that, because you don't have a Christian background, right? He wasn't expecting somebody who was a former Catholic to come and call him out on that. And that's how these Christian apologists are. They're very deceptive, lying people who have this irrational hatred against Islam, and that's why they do what they do. They look in through the in Islamic texts, the Quran and Hadith, not to find the truth, but to find something that they can hang on to so they can cause doubts amongst the Muslims and to appeal to their audience in order to prevent Christians from becoming Muslim. That's all they do. So he knew what he was doing was a heresy. So what I want you all to do is to share this video to them and say, by your own standards, not Muslim standards, by your own very own Chalcedonian Christian standards, you guys are heretics. So what's up? You know what I'm saying? What's up? Okay, so like, subscribe, share, hit me up on Patreon. Salam alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.